might become a question of prestige and might create a socio-economic divide between the ones who can afford to have it and the ones who cannot. We made sure to consider these points during our deliberations. Now, I will be talking to you all about the technical specifications of Peniche. Peniche, a pen with futuristic elegance. As the technology department, our team realized that we would play a crucial role in both the development of the product as well as the development of the company itself. We had to take care of dual responsibilities. On the one hand, we had to create a plan and execute the technicality of the product. And on the other hand, we had to take care of the technological needs and necessities to run the company. After extensive deliberation, we discussed this matter with related departments and started working on the model. After a lot of collaboration and work, we decided to omit some of the initial features and also add some of them. This here is the final model of Peniche. Peniche is a universal stylus, meaning it can be used on any of the latest touchscreen devices. The aluminium body gives it a sleek look along with the sturdiness it needs. The latest Bluetooth version 5.0 helps you connect and communicate with surrounding devices at surprisingly fast speeds. A built-in microphone and speakers help you make use of the pen with almost no effort at all. An inbuilt 64 megapixel dual camera along with flash helps you take pictures on a moment's notice. A SIM slot is present that can be used to insert 4G and 5G SIM cards. An auxiliary port is also present to help you insert your favorite audio devices. An inbuilt automatic graphene pullout screen that brings you a small touchscreen helps you perform basic activities such as taking notes. Finally, the indicator light, which tells you about your device's current condition, such as the available battery, Bluetooth connection status, etc. This is our product, Peniche. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening, everyone. This is Nikhil, head of the branding department. Initially, we weren't sure of the main elements that we would have to incorporate in our logo. So we had just come up with a few sample logos for our company using various graphic design platforms such as Canva. Later on, we had a few discussions with the CEO and the advisors of our company. And then we conducted extensive research on to understand the benefits of having an attractive logo for a company. Then we also analyzed the various mistakes that many companies commit while making their logos. So finally, we worked on improving the background color, the shape, the font style, and also the design of our logo. We also came up with two taglines for our company, but we weren't yet sure about which one of the two taglines to choose. So since the final decision rests with the CEO and the advisors, we again approached our CEO and the advisors for their opinions about our logo and the tagline. They suggested minor changes in our logo, and at the same time, we also finalized the tagline for our company. Later on, we collaborated with the marketing department for the design specifications of our logo. Finally, we came up with a unique logo along with a catchy tagline for our company. Thank you. Over to Shambhavi from the marketing department.
Okay, so the tech team has made an amazing product, and the branding department is promoting our product. The marketing department? Well, let me split what we have been doing into three different parts. Who it's sold to, why do people need this product, and how will people access this product? The goal of a company being to satisfy the needs of a businessman, the obvious target market would be business people. Apart from business people, every student would be interested in this new out-of-space amazing gadget. I'm not going to go into the psychology of it. Now, why would people need this product? You all know its features, the microphone, speakers, and all of that, but what makes it so good? All of it is in one. It's efficient, it's easy to access, and most importantly, it's really hard to lose, unlike most tiny gadgets which we use nowadays. Now, how will we get this to the world? How will we tell this, why this product is so amazing to the world? It's just a quote I read somewhere. To stop advertising to save money is like stopping your watch to save time. We're going to advertise on TV, on social media, and even on go a little bit old school and even on billboards. To advertise it, we've made a script. Which shows all the features and how this pen will be used in your everyday life. We also worked in collaboration with the tech team to work on the visual appeal of this product. If you were to go to a restaurant, the number of stars the restaurant has is not just dependent on the food, it's also dependent on the aesthetic of the restaurant. Similarly, you want a really, really good-looking pen if you want people to go there and buy it. In fact, we've also made a website. Tanish has made the website, and he will be showing it to you shortly. But for a minute, I'll ask you to hold your horses. Now, how will people find out how to use this product? And if there's any problem, who will the people come to? Us. And to get the number one satisfaction from all our customers, we've decided to add a customer service department into our underneath marketing department. And last but not least, before I pass the mic on to Tanish, I'd like to end with a quote. We're not looking for the perfect customers for our product. We are looking for the perfect product for our customers. Thank you.
Good evening to one and all present here. I'm Tanish Tejas, VMS of Grade 7 from the Marketing Department. And I'll be showing the website which we have developed. So this is the website which we have developed. So we thought of mainly dividing the website into 9 parts: the home, about, CEO, product, contact, FAQ, shop, subscribe, and the testimonial page. So I'll start off with the home page. So home page has the company's name and its tagline, Penish, a pen with futuristic elegance, the logo. Below that, there is a notification tab which will alert the users when there's a new product launch or when there's a new discount. Below that, there's an image tag. These are the few images of our product. Next is the About page. So About page has about the company's ambition, mission, and the vision. The CEO's page mainly has the thoughts of the CEO, the business model, why India and why Mysore, social media, how do we engage, what is our expectations with ATL and why. Here is the photo of our mentor, Srinath sir, and our advisors, Lekha ma'am and Pramila ma'am. So the product page has the image of the model of the pen and the major features of the pen. So next is the video of the pen. So this is made with Tinkercad and Paint 3D. The contact page has the contact information of the company, like the address, the email ID, the phone number, and the department heads. So next is the FAQ page. FAQ page is a drop-down based FAQ where the user can see the frequently asked questions. So below that, there is a text, ask a question. So if the user wants to ask a question, by clicking on the text, that will go to an inquiry form where the user needs to fill the basic details like the email, name, phone number and can ask the question. So next is the shop page. Shop page has few links where the user can purchase the product, like the Amazon, which will lead to the Amazon page. So Flipkart, Snapdeal, eBay, etc. So next is the subscribe page. So user can subscribe to Penish. So the user will be notified when we launch a new product or when we have a new discount. So I will subscribe to the company. So subscribe to the company, and as you can see, I've received the mail in the company's mailbox with the same details I've entered there. So the next page is the testimonial page. So in the testimonial page, there are few testimonials from the mentors and the parents. So for developing this website, we have mainly used HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and a bit of PHP. Thank you. Over to Anushree, HOD of HR department.
Good evening, all. I'm Anushree, the HR department lead. I'm going to brief you about the work of the HR department. The human resource department is responsible for making the workforce of an organization. In our company, Penich, we have divided the role of the human resource department into four main parts. They are recruitment of employees, training of employees, recording performance of employees, and collecting and storing data of the company. So first, recruitment of employees. We will employ the locals and follow situational employment. This will help us to market our product at the local level. We will also advertise for jobs on various social media platforms. The training of employees is going to be done using constructive training session plans so that all our employees get the necessary skills and knowledge needed for the job. For keeping a track of the employees' performance, like their participation in the work, their attendance, the leaves taken, etc., we're going to take a report from the respective department heads. As for the collecting and storing of data of the company, we're going to store the data of each employee as well as of the company using Google Drive. Thank you. Over to Akash from the finance department.
Good evening, everyone. I am Akash Savanur, and I will be representing the finance department. I will be briefing you about the work we did and how we functioned as employees in a company. We began by defining our roles and functions as employees of the finance department. We researched about the importance of the finance sector in a company, and we started to learn the intricacies of general accounting, planning, budgeting, and funding. First, we started off by learning how to create a business budget. We learned that creating a business budget was essential as to give clarity on where money will be spent monthly or annually. A budget is also necessary to regulate expenses, which would lead to increased savings. We worked on how the cash flow of the company can be monitored carefully and periodically, since cash flow is the oxygen of any business. Next, our priority was to raise capital for the newly established company, Penish, in Mysuru. Since Penish was already a well-established corporation in the United States, we decided a part of the profit could be used as an initial investment to establish the company in Mysuru. We also shortlisted some additional methods to raise capital for the business. These were self-funding, crowdfunding, angel investors, bank loans, and venture capital investment. The main functions of the finance department will begin after the launch of the company. We will be performing the general accounting of the company, and we will be controlling all the corporation's monetary affairs. Thank you, and I'm handing it over to Siddhant from the operations department.
Good evening, all. This is Siddhant Achya, the head of the operations at Penish. Thank all the guests present here for giving me a chance to present our department's workflow. Being the head of the department, there were many priorities and objectives that I had to keep into account. As a team, we were initially confused about what to do exactly. After having conversations with the CEO and the mentor, we were on track. We improvised in our decision-making abilities and set objectives that we had to follow before digging deep with the work. We trained ourselves and managed to grasp the roles of the operations department. The objectives have been responsible for the smooth running of the various business activities in the company. As mentioned, the operations keeping the business running efficiently, ensuring overall quality of the company, delivery of services and products at the right time. Now coming to the resource and equipment extraction. It is the prior duty of the operations to create an energetic office environment. We had received material lists from all departments. We came up with a specialized questionnaire for the tech department. We broadly classified the materials into high-performance computer systems, general office equipment, broadband connections, and office decor. We studied and came up with a budget-effective product list with certain strategies. To conclude, the strategies we provided were implemented by the marketing department. This was based on promoting regional businesses in and around Mysore, which are under problems. The problems included running out of money during crucial production activities, inexperience in managing a business, and poorly planned or executed marketing strategies. We also came up with our own motto, a smooth running business, a better environment. Finally, we could execute most of what we had prioritized. Thank you.
Thank you, team. Thank you, Inchara, and your entire team. It was really a nice experience to hear you share your experiences in this project. Before I move on, I would request one of the advisors, Ms. Lekha Nair, to quickly talk about what she thinks was the learning that the children would have got from this program. She has been able to gather their feedback. Lekha, over to you.
Thank you, Prashant sir. So my role as an ATL in charge, along with Ms. Pramila, my colleague, was that of an advisor to the company. So this team is a mixed bag of students across classes 7 to 12. They have diverse aptitude and has displayed amazing interdependency skills. Critical thinking, which is one of the essential skills required for the 21st century learners, was developed while designing the product and setting up the process. Since there was no tangible product as an outcome, it was left to the students to take it to the zenith of their imagination. So I would rather say that space was the limit rather than the sky is the limit. With regards to communication and collaboration skills, especially during these testing times, technology has helped them to conduct meetings with ease. Meetings were organized between the CEO and the department leads, between the department leads and the team members using various platforms. On an average, apart from the formal meeting which we had with the mentor of change, the advisor, and the Penish team, there were 6 to 7 informal meetings within the respective departments. Some of the parents who were closely monitoring this program commented that at times they thought this product actually existed. The decision-making skills were developed by giving them choices to decide the department they wish to be in and reasoning why they chose them. During the initial phases of the project, there were heated discussions on which department should initiate the process. We did not intervene. They had to figure it out by themselves, how to move ahead. Each department started researching on success and failures of different companies. They explored various websites, took help from professionals, and interacted with their relatives and friends. And in this process, students not only learned the terminologies, but have also developed good number of skills, whether it is a soft skill or skills on using tools to give shape to their company. So this project was unique in a lot of aspects. Though there were differences of opinion within and between the teams, they were willing to consider different perspectives explore different alternatives, examine the diverse point of view, and of course, value and respect others' ideas. They all worked based on the strength and weaknesses of their team members. Personally, I felt this program has given students confidence to dream big. Students started believing that accepting challenges helped them to grow stronger, and failures brought them closer to their goals. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Lekha. That was insightful. Right. So moving on, as you would have imagined, the program is not complete yet. We are still in the process of, process of the project. We are still going through various, activities in the project. We are currently at a stage where the children have come up with the product, ideated the product, and then come out with their plans. The next steps obviously would be to conduct a more detailed market survey, get an exposure of how market survey is conducted, do a detailed costing and pricing, and then do an overall business plan, maybe prepare a pitch to the investors. You know, there are steps to be taken going forward. All of these are in the program to be done. I would definitely think, which Srinath also always talks about, that we can create this more like a framework and put it all together where this is replicable. Of course, we would want to replicate year after year and for more children in the school, but also I think this can be a replicable model by any Atalin Tinkering Lab or any other institution for that matter. So we are very keen that we put it all together as a framework and present it to Atal Innovation Mission. Sir, I see Mr. Ramanan joining. Thank you very much for joining, sir. A very, very hearty welcome from Excel Public School ATL. It's been a great honor to have you in our program. I'm sure you would have got a sense of what we have been talking about so far, sir. So I would now request you to kindly, if you would like to interact with the students, please feel free to interact with them, sir. And primarily, we would request you to deliver a keynote and then, some feedback and most importantly, advice to all of us as to how can we take this forward and, materialize more things from out of this experiment. Mr. Ramanan, sir, floor is yours, please.
Thank you, Prashant, and thank you, Srinath, for arranging this program along with Ronak, the operational management lead from Atal Innovation Mission on Atal Tinkering Labs. It is indeed a pleasure and privilege for me to listen to all the young students, and these are the budding innovators who are going to make an impact upon New India. The whole idea of this Atal Innovation Mission was to encourage such youngsters to start thinking about how they can be the architects of new products, new solutions that would be useful to the marketplace, that would be useful to the communities in which we are in, and that would enable our country to grow both economically and from a societal point of view. And as the young students pointed out very, very effectively in their presentations, and I want to congratulate all of them from the Excel Public School for having taken interest in understanding from an idea to a product that is commercially deployable and into the market. There are many, many steps that need to be taken in order for it to succeed. First, you start with a problem that you see or you anticipate which you want to solve. And then once you have looked at the problem or a series of problems and identified some problem that you want to solve or you want to improve, there may be a solution, but that solution may not be an effective solution. It may not be a good solution. And you have seen the limitations of that solution and you want to make sure that you are able to develop a new solution. So the problem could be either creating a solution to something where there is no solution or improvising on a particular solution that already exists, but which is having limitations. And that is where you start ideating a solution. So first you understand the problem, but you have to also do research on that problem. If you do research, you understand the various dimensions of that problem. Why is the problem happening? it is not that the problem may be a manifestation of certain underlying causes. So how do you identify these causes? Are these technical causes? Are these people-related causes? Are they process-related causes? Is it something that has not been implemented properly? There may be many aspects to this, the reason why the problem exists. And therefore, a research on the problem itself, the causes, as well as what are the other solutions which are out there for that problem? Are there solutions out there which have been trying to address this problem? And you know, you don't want to be reinventing the wheel. You want to create a unique solution for a problem that has either not been solved before or a new unique solution for the improvisation of the solution. So that is very important, and therefore research is very important. And then from that research springs the idea of how to solve this problem. And then once you have found the idea, then you have to work on that idea. You know, that's your imagination at work. That is your creative potential that you have in you. So you start working on that idea and start putting together various pieces of a solution. The idea gives birth to the solution, but the solution consists of many pieces. Often today, it is a combination of technology, it is a combination of software, it is a combination of mechanical or what they call as mechatronics. There may be many elements to the solution. If it is an agricultural problem, it could be trying to understand the needs of the particular crop that you are trying to grow, the soil conditions under which you're trying to grow, the climate conditions around you in which that crop is required to grow, the fertilizers and the pesticides and the effect of that on the crops that you want to grow. There are many aspects to the problem, and some of them will require technology-led solutions. Some of them would require a process-based solution. Some of them may require just people, you know, being skilled in doing something and developing the necessary skills. And that is how you get a solution, for example, called precision agriculture. Precision agriculture is how do you have the right conditions for a particular crop to flower and to blossom in the shortest possible manner with the least amount of cost, but with the maximum amount of productivity and effect. So that, and now you will have IoT technology built into it. You may have satellite communication technologies coming into it. So you will need to put together a solution that has multiple aspects which require to be focused on. And that is why you'll require a team like how you have formed. And then comes the solution itself, the prototyping of the solution. So you prototype the solution and you create a prototype and you say, does this work? And yes, it does. So now comes the, from your baby has just been born. It is like, you know, in 9 months, the baby is born, but the baby is not a full grown adult. And you have to make your prototype into a full blown product, a product that is creating an impact upon the mother. Just like a baby blossoms into a beautiful human being. And there is a lot of effort that goes, reiterations, attention, care, improvisations. It has to be nurtured, and fodder has to be given to the child, good food, nutritious food has to be given, training and skill development has to be done on the child. Similarly, for your product, which has been just born, it's like a baby, your own baby. So how do you nurture it into a full-grown product? Now, once you make it into a full-grown product, then all the other things come in which you have talked about. How am I going to market this product? What is the team that I'm going to build in order to be able to even evolve this product further? There is a technical team required. There is a design team required. There is a HR team required in order to make sure that the right people get inducted into your company. Because now you're starting to form a startup, and a startup is growing into a company. You will need to know how to market this product. You will need to know what digital marketing is all about and what are the tools available for you to reach across the market. You need a communications department which is able to communicate what is the problem that you have solved, how your problem is so unique in terms of its solution, and how you are going to reach across the market. You need the finance expert like your team had, where the finance person is going to say, this is how I'm going to run this company in terms of the inflow of money that I'm going to get, the expenses that I'm going to handle, and the profitability of the enterprise. Unless an organization is profitable, unless a startup becomes profitable, unless it's able to stand on its own leg soon without having the support of others, it will have what they call as the valleys of death in the startup life cycle. Also, you need a department for strategy. What is going to be my strategy to penetrate the market? What's going to be my strategy for presenting the product? How do I add features, functionality that the user needs? And then you have a support department, which is required to support the product in its implementation. You know, many great companies, many great products have simply died because you have not been able to support the product once it has been sold to the customers. And then the customers get tired of the product, they find some flaws, they are not able to access the helpline, they are not getting the adequate type of responses that is needed from the organization, and then they lose interest in that product and they go into some other competitive product, and the competitive product gains market share. That's what has happened to many companies. You know, many companies just die because they have had poor service associated with the implementation of their product or with the sales of their product. And then you need a good sales team, which has to go out and find new customers. Without that sales team, you will not be able to run the campaigns effectively, be able to convince the customers that your product is different from others. You know, you don't start word of mouth, social media, how you're going to use social media, how you're going to use personal presentations, how your presentation can be very effective, like the ones which you are doing. All of these elements come into it. And then you have a HR strategy. You know, how am I going to induct some of the best people? And how am I going to retain them? That is important. You know, your product success is based upon how good people you are able to attract, you're able to retain, and who are going to support the further evolution of your product. So that's very important. And then you have corporate governance. How am I going to ensure that I maintain all the records? I have a department which is focusing on the corporate governance part of it. All of this becomes very important. So, you know, there is a huge cycle of from an idea to a product that finds a place in the market and it succeeds. And I think I have to compliment this entire team today for having walked through that cycle, because that is the cycle that everyone, every company, every startup, every entrepreneur, everyone who wants to be successful will have to go through. And it is really fantastic that not only the ATL in charge, but also the mentors of change associated with this with this school have played a very important role in coming up with all of this. So I do wish all of you tremendous success. Your innovation journey has just begun. And remember that an innovation journey is a never-ending journey. You constantly learn. In an innovator's life or in an entrepreneur's life, there is nothing called failure. There is only a first attempt in learning, as Abdul Kalam said. And every step is a first attempt in learning and continuous steps of learning. Because it is in that learning that your product evolves, you evolve, your organization evolves, and your company evolves. And therefore, all of these are very, very important steps. And I'm very happy that you have shared this with a whole lot of other schools. I am particularly delighted that the Atal Tinkering Labs has ushered in a revolution in the schools. It's a game changer. You know, I never used to think about all of this when I was your age, when I was in grade 6 to grade 12. I mean, I had no idea about what innovation was about, what product development is about, what a company is about. I had no idea. And you have already started thinking like a chief executive of a company, thinking like a HR officer of the company, thinking like the chief digital marketing strategist of the company. So that is a wonderful thing. I think this is going to help India really become wonderful, become a leader in the global marketplace. And more importantly, all of you young students will become the job creators of the future. So thank you so much for giving me an opportunity to learn a bit today from all of you. and keep up the good work. All the very best.
Thank you, sir. Nice information you have shared, and beautiful words, actually. You've given a lot of motivation to these young students. Definitely, you know, we all have not learned in our time, actually. But great, you know, thank you very much, sir, with your, you know, for taking time and, you know, just having a given all that talk, actually. Thank you very much, sir. I'll hand over to Prashant, sir. He just want to share something with you.
Thank you.
Thank you very, very much from our side, sir, from the entire team. I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude and thanks for taking out your time, sir. Very, very useful inputs, like what Srinath said. Really motivating, inspirational words for the students to think over. I'm sure it was something like, you know, 7 steps or 12 steps for setting up a successful enterprise. It was as much as a ready reckoner. Your speech was like that. I'm sure this recording we will watch over and over again, and then the students will really, really benefit from it. Thank you very much, sir.
I would like if all the students turn their videos on, we can take a picture together. It is a privilege to be associated with all the students.
Wonderful. Wonderful, sir.
So can all the students turn it on?
All students, if you are two of them together, maybe you could all come on one screen. Yes.
Yeah.
Maintain social distance.
Yeah. Okay.
Siddhant, your screen. And then the other two screens. Siddhant is there. Where are the others? No.
Some of them are off.
Sit down. Oh, yeah. Okay.
Ronak, you can also come online. I can see your...
Aditi and others, you are on the corner. You should just walk to your right, please.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, yeah. They are all there.
Wonderful. Okay.
Everybody smile. Give your best smile. Except those who are in face masks, you can't That's okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
I think the center one is off.
I think they moved into
Okay. One more has come.
All right, one more. Everybody smile. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you, sir. Yeah, all the best. I will have to move on to something else, but I want to compliment all the young students.
Sir, if I may request for another 5 minutes at the mess, we have our founder secretary, Mr. Sudhanva, on the call. Mr. Sure. Sudhanva is the founder of Excel Soft Technologies, which is a company. He's the CEO and MD, as well as the secretary of the school. I would request Mr. Sudhanva to deliver the concluding remarks and talk about what his feedback is on the program.
Sure. Go ahead. Yeah, the students relax. You don't have to stand there. You can relax. Good.
Thank you all. Thank you, Ramanan sir. Thank you for really motivating speech and motivating words to our students. Your name is so synonymous with Atal Innovation Mission. We have had the opportunity to read a lot about you, read a lot about your work and the positive impact you have been making right across the country. And it's very fortunate that we have you today on our program. And I'm personally delighted to see you and listen to you, sir. And thank you so much for taking your time out and for extending it for a few more minutes. Prashant, Srinath, Matthew, all of you who've been involved in ideating and making this event happen, very good. And thank you very much for your efforts, and Matthew as well. I know he's online. I'm very positively surprised about how well articulated the presentation was. It was like a real business pitch, a pitch that a promoter or a startup makes. I have been an investor myself in many startups, and you know, if this was a real startup, I think I would be quite interested in looking at an investment. It was truly interesting. You know, at this age, I'm extremely delighted. At this age, they are able to communicate so well, have so much of clarity in thinking, and kind of have discovered this entrepreneurship journey, the role play, the teamwork, etc. I think I've been an entrepreneur pretty much all my career, and I think it's the spirit of entrepreneurship and the spirit of enterprise is in our minds, and it's about being optimistic at all times, taking on challenges head on, and as Ramanan sir said, solving problems which can make a difference and social impact. That's very important, and I think for the nation today, even pre-COVID, post-COVID times, I think it's important that we see more and more entrepreneurs come out and build big businesses for the country to truly succeed from an economic and business leadership sense. I think the journey has begun. As Ramanan sir said, when we were in school, we were not fortunate enough to even have heard the word entrepreneurship, let alone be given an opportunity like this to role play and create a business scenario. Very, very good start to it. I hope we do more such meaningful projects. Thank you, sir, Ramanan sir. Thank you, Srinath. Thank you, Prashant, Matthew, the EPS team, the mentors, and most of all, congratulations to all the students who have participated in it. I know it requires a lot of focus, lot of effort, and we should all applaud you for it. And I hope you continue your journey of entrepreneurship. Thank you all.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for your encouraging words. There is one section which would be coming in 2 days, which is interaction with a successful entrepreneur, and you would be the candidate for that.
Thank you so much for giving me an opportunity to participate in that and to listen to all the young students. Very inspiring. Keep it up. And as Mr. Kalam said, as the great Kalam said, dream big and you'll achieve great things. Dream small and you'll be limited by your own dreams. So don't be limited by your own dreams. Dream big, aspire, be confident, and I'm sure you will make it happen. All the very best.
Wonderful, sir. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Nice.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Mr. Ron, left. Okay. Mr. Ronak also left. I think with those, I think we can conclude the session. Thank you very much, all the students. Really appreciate your effort. Thank you very much, Sudama sir. It much appreciated. Your presence made a big difference to the motivation of the students. Thank you. Thank you very much from the bottom of my heart. Matthew, thank you very much for your support. Srinath sir, all the advisors, thank you. Thank you, one and all. Thank you.
Thanks, sir. Thanks to all. Thanks, Sudhanva, sir. Thanks, principal, sir, everybody.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Srinath.
Thanks, sir.
Thanks. All very right. good. All very right. good. Very well done.
Thank you.
Signing off. Thank you. Signing off. Bye-bye.